We all know that the dinosaurs went extinct because of an asteroid that hit our planet, in that many species have gone extinct since then. However, some animals disappear on our planet not as the result of an asteroid, but as a consequence of human action. In fact, humans have wiped out nearly two-thirds of animal species in the past 50 years. That is mainly the reason why you've never heard of the lovely Sardinian Pika, the orange frog that uses its croaking to warn people of impending rain, or the Tasmanian wolf. However, the fascinating thing about what we will discover today is that genetic engineering may enable us to see these extinct animals. But the question is, would it truly be a miracle, or is it something we should avoid? Well, to get the answers, let's not waste any time and get this exciting new discovery to begin. This topic drew a lot of attention when Australian photographer Neil Waters shared a shocking picture of the Tasmanian wolf on the internet. Many were shocked because the wolf was thought to be gone about 85 years ago, so it's possible that scientists have already been successful in cloning, but the issue remains whether it's really worth it. But first, I need to introduce you to the many extinct species so you can decide whether or not they should be resurrected. The Haast's eagle is the first animal on the list. This is the largest bird in the historical era. The harpy eagle, the world's largest eagle, is extremely similar to this species. The only difference was that it was weighed twice as much and had a 40% larger wingspan, until mankind cruelly killed this exquisite bird. It could be found throughout New Zealand's South Island, but why does humanity decide to kill this bird? Haast's eagle's primary food source is the mao. Thus, when people eradicated it, the huge bird started attacking the kids of the residents. That was the time when the Maori people had to kill the bird for self-defense, in order to save their children. Although this incident demonstrated that humans are the most terrible hunters and killers of all time, the Maori people's actions allowed their children to play freely and safely, without fear of being taken away by a vengeful bird. Another extinct animal on the list is Megalania. This is the world's largest land lizard, according to scientists. It was the length of a two-story structure and weighed as much as a blue whale's heart. This too could not escape a human being's ruthlessness. It's important to note that the Megalania is a lizard that hunts its victims in a surprise attack fashion. That implies that it will confine you instantaneously by piercing your tendons with its razor-sharp fangs. It kills its prey in the same way as to how we open chips by cutting through the middle of the bag, meaning in an instant, it will rip open your stomach and begin eating you alive right away. It's a shame that such a species has gone extinct, but given how dangerous this animal is, if you had a chance to kill it, would you really refuse to do so? There was a rumor at the end of the 1900s, at the end of the 1990s, that Megalania had been spotted in Australia or New Guinea. Perhaps it is still alive despite the lack of cloning. The giant short-faced bear is next on this list. The giant short-faced bear is twice the height of a human, weighs more than a rhinoceros, and is 50% larger than the largest polar bear. To survive, it must ingest 35 pounds of meat every single day. Because of its unusual ultra-sensitive nose, it has little trouble locating its prey. Unlike Megalania, the bear's lateral teeth will successfully tear not just its prey's tendons, but also its bones. Moreover, its fangs are directed in different directions, similar to a tiger. With all this information, it's no wonder why humans eliminated everything that the giant short-faced bear and the Megalania ate. It's also probable that as soon as these predators crossed their paths, mankind didn't think twice about killing them. The extinction of such animals was necessary for ancient people to live freely. And what about the Tasmanian wolf, though? What harm did it cause to humans? Before we continue, I just want to remind you that if you've made it this far into the video, you're clearly enjoying it. Give it a like, subscribe so you don't miss anything, and let us know what you think in the comments section. In 1936, the Tasmanian wolf, commonly known as the thylacine, became extinct. Yes, this species existed at the time of the invention of the camera, which is why we can still see its actual photographs up to this day. It looks like a large cat with a unique striped pattern. When it yawns, it expands its mouth at a 90-degree angle. Some say this striped cat isn't completely harmless. It's still not a good idea, though, to put your finger in its mouth. That would be extremely risky. In 2005, the Australian publication The Bulletin offered a reward of $1.25 million to anyone who could catch a live thylacine. After capturing a shot of an entire family of thylacines, including a cub, Neil Waters, the president of Thylacine Evernote, became a billionaire. Perhaps the thylacine he discovered roaming through the woods is a product of successful cloning studies and will soon be able to restore other recently extinct animals I've mentioned. The idea of cloning extinct animals was first proposed by scientists from the University of New South Wales Lazarus Project. Initially, scientists used tissue from a frog that had been preserved since the 1970s. They then inserted it into an egg of another frog species that are closely related. Despite the fact that none of the embryos survived, this is still the first step of mankind's efforts in making the Jurassic Park scenario exist in real life. And because we're talking about a park, I think it would be fascinating to include the Helicoprion in a community of cloned animals from the past. This predatory fish has very strong teeth. They never fell out, but instead formed a wheel-like pattern on the lower jaw. Helicoprion was used to execute Paleozoic chainsaw massacres with its fatal teeth. When it's put inside a giant glass aquarium in a park, many visitors would be fascinated in seeing Helicoprion, and that may even be Steven Spielberg, who would be inspired to create another film featuring this character in a major role. The list also includes the Aquililamna Melicare. It has a better chance of resurrecting because on March 18th, scientists announced the discovery of a preserved Cretaceous shark fossil in the Gulf of Mexico. It has pectoral fins that mimic wings and looks like a stingray imprisoned within a shark's body. Of course, we should not miss talking about the Entelodont. Entelodont is a giant cannibal pig with an 8-inch fang. If you want to keep it, you need to make sure you're not the faint-hearted type. If your dog isn't doing its job securing your home, you should know that robbers would be a perfect match for Entelodont. Let's only hope that it doesn't injure its owner. It's remarkable that cloning is the only way to restore these rare species. These animals all failed to avoid extinction and elimination, despite their strength and ferocity. The honey badger, on the other hand, is a relatively invincible animal. Honey badger may be cute at first glance, but I wouldn't recommend approaching it. This creature is absolutely insane. The honey badger is the most courageous animal in the world, not only because of its thick, elastic skin that is difficult to bite through, but also because it is the first to engage in battles and scraps. Do you know about the online celebrity honey badger who has repeatedly escaped its confinement? No, it didn't become free in the wild. Instead, it went to attack other zoo animals. The honey badger is similar to someone causing chaos during a party and not being able to be stopped. When the honey badger fights, it employs prohibited methods. It has the ability to severely attack its victim's face and eyes. Honey badger's jaws are so strong, they can consume turtles within their shells. And even if this animal becomes the food of a predator, the predator would not be able to swallow it because it is also highly dodgy. Perhaps you can travel to Africa and view it up close, but be aware that it can scratch your eyeballs out within the first few minutes of looking at it. You might be wondering how wonderful it would be if all the animals on our list were as tough as the honey badger and were able to live to this day. Since 1999, scientists have been attempting to recreate the Tasmanian wolf. Its DNA was extracted 3 years later, but it was discovered to be useless. Scientists were able to make some of the thylacine genes operate in the mouse embryo. Sadly, none of the developing embryos transformed into wolves. After that, scientists fell silent, and we could feel relieved knowing that we wouldn't run into any of these amazing but terrible creatures from the past. However, as I mentioned at the beginning of the video, photographs of a Tasmanian wolf wandering quietly through the Tasmanian wolves were captured in 2021. It led to the conclusion that the trials may have gotten out of hand, and that photographs of such extinct animals strolling near humans may soon be available on the internet. We may simply fail to notice them. So how about you? What animals would you like to resurrect and display in your yard? Would it be the Tasmanian wolf, the ancient short-faced bear, the cannibal pig, the chainsaw fish, or the baby killer eagle? Aren't you curious as to why humans can't resurrect themselves? Cloning Neanderthals is the most realistic solution. There will be matching surrogate species, and we are one of them. Human cloning, on the other hand, is prohibited by the UN Declaration, which considers it unethical. Would you want to be in charge of rearing a Neanderthal? Is there someone you'd like to bring back to life? And if so, who would it be? Let us know in the comments section. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Please click the bell icon so you'll be notified when new videos are posted. And as always, thanks for watching Ponder This.